We are all getting the house ready for Easter, so we've been excited to have back our DIY expert, Julie Lovin, aka the Effortless Girl, with another great budget-friendly project. Thanks for being back with us today, Julie.
Hi, happy almost Easter.
So excited. So what great projects do you have for us today? Because I always love the budget-friendly ideas that you have.
Right. So I'm going to start with these are flower vases, obviously. But the cool thing about these flower vases, and you can put your spring flowers in them, are they are Pringles potato chip cans. So they have just been spray painted. So you probably, if you eat Pringles, you're going to have these in your house anyway. So don't throw it out, just paint it. And then you can use it for a beautiful vase. You could do some metallic colors too, which would be really elegant. But I use pastels for spring. And I think filled with spring flowers, they are so pretty. And nobody really has to know that the Pringles can. They've just recycled. So it's kind of a two-pronged thing, but I love them. I think they're beautiful and very budget-friendly. But the other project that I'm going to show you, and I think these are so adorable, is Easter Bunny napkin rings. And these are so simple to make. I'm going to show you right now. You just want to use a paper towel or a toilet paper holder in the center and cut it down to napkin size, napkin ring size. Now you can do a small napkin ring or a larger one. It's really up to you. It's just whatever you prefer, really. What you want to do is wrap the napkin ring with a piece of spring fabric or burlap. I love burlap, so I'm obsessed with that. But just wrap it, and then you want to glue, you want to tuck the insides, the top sides, insides in to the napkin ring so you have more of a finished edge. Hot glue is easier. You could probably use regular glue, but it's going to take a little bit longer to dry. But also the thing with hot glue is don't burn yourself. And I say this because I'm preaching to myself because I do all the time. So once you let that dry, that's what the napkin ring itself looks like, which I think is really pretty and nobody has to know it's a toilet tissue roll. And then cut cardboard ears. Bunny ears are never the same, so they don't have to be perfect, just something ear size. And wrap it in the same fabric that you use for your napkin ring. Or you could use different if you wanted two different bunny ears, but that's okay. And glue it on with your hot glue. You see how much time this takes. It's very quick once everything is cut. And then you have your bunny ears made. Now I'm gonna let that dry for just a second. So what you want to do after that is cut a small hole in the top of the napkin ring and then just place your bunny ears in it. And I'm gonna show you how that some of these ears have already, you wanna, you know, the ears aren't perfect and you can glue them in if you want, or you can just stick them in the hole that you cut. You just wanna cut a little slit. And then if you do that, you can pull them out and store them for next year. But I think these are so adorable. They're perfect for Easter. They make little cute Easter gifts too, but for Easter lunch or Easter dinner, whichever you, if you celebrate that, I think these are so seasonal and they cost literally under 50 cents per napkin ring. And where are you going to find that? And really your time investment is minimal. So it's very doable right now.
Yeah, that looks like a great project. And I love that you can carry it into spring, of course, because the bunnies apply all spring long. All right.
Sure.
Thanks, Julie. Thanks so much for the great ideas. Where can people go for more on this project and all the other great ideas that you've got?
Yep. This how-to is on the website right now. It's at effortlessgirl.com and follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at The Effortless Girl.
Awesome. Thank you again, Julie. I appreciate you being here. And of course, happy Easter.
Happy Easter.